At this place in history, we're on the campus of the University of Vermont in Burlington. And of course, joining me, the Executive Director of the Vermont Historical Society, Steve Perkins.
We're going to be talking about the Marquis de Lafayette.
Okay.
That's his shortened name. He's got a really long name.
Ooh, do you know it?
I can't recite it. It's got like 50 words in it.
No worries.
Knows him as Lafayette.
So give us a refresher on who he is.
The Marquis de Lafayette was one of the Frenchmen, French military officers who came over to the fledgling United States and helped us win the American Revolution. He became this kind of larger than life hero for American servicemen. And Lafayette actually named his son George Washington Lafayette.
Wow.
So that's who he is. But why is his statue, you know, here in Vermont? So we have to take us back to the 1820s. We are coming up on the 50th anniversary of the United States, 1826. A lot of Revolutionary War soldiers were dying off, and he said, what kind of big splash can we make to get everyone all excited about this 50-year anniversary of our country? Great, we'll invite one of the great French generals who helped us back. So Lafayette was the only one who was still left alive at the time. So they invited him to come do a grand tour of the United States, where there are 24 of them at the time. So he landed in New York in 1824, in the summer of 1824, and he spent almost 18 months here. Like any tour, I mean, this was huge. He was greeted by parades and speeches and dinners everywhere he went. And of course, all sorts of product was sold. I actually brought a product with me. This is a sandwich glass plate, and it has the ship, the Cadmus, which Lafayette sailed on to come to the United States. So during his actual trip, glass companies were producing things like this to sell to people to remember that trip. And you can see there's Lafayette stuff all over the place in antique markets, and that's what it comes from. So he came to Vermont at the very tail end of his trip, and he came up through New Hampshire, and on the morning of the 28th of June, he crossed the Windsor-Cornish covered bridge into Windsor, Vermont, and then started this trek up through. Everywhere he stopped, he had a reception, they ate, they drank. I can't imagine doing that today.
A lot of pomp and circumstance.
Exactly. He was doing this in carriages on rough roads and going all the way from Windsor to Montpelier. The governor, of course, accompanied him the whole way, and he stayed at a beautiful house called the Cadwell House, and all the best furniture from all of the region was loaned to the owner of that house, so his house could be completely outfitted in the best furniture for the Marquis de Lafayette. The next morning, get up, and they hit the road, and they head out, ending up here in Burlington, which was the college town in the home of the governor, Cornelius Van Ness.
So what is this building we're standing in front of now?
We're standing in front of what's called the Old Mill Building, and it's one of the oldest buildings on campus. Now, the very first UVM building was erected right on this site, but in 1824, it burned down. Hmm. So when Lafayette came to visit, this made the perfect opportunity to lay a ceremonial cornerstone for the brand new UVM building.
So now we're on the last stop of our recreation, our mini recreation of Lafayette's tour. Where are we?
So we're in front of what we now know as Grassmount. Lafayette spent his final evening at a grand party in this house, which was owned by the governor of Vermont at the time. They had bands on the lawn, they had big celebratory arches welcoming Lafayette, and apparently they partied well into the night here before then rolling the Marquis down the hill and put him on the steamship Phoenix, where he headed on down to New York.
At this place in history.